The hero of our story is an osprey, a bird of prey, and he's on his way north, answering that inner call. From somewhere along the coast of South America, he set his course for one specific shoreline, some 4,000 miles away. Our osprey, it turns out, is a New Englander at heart. And he's heading home. Weighing just 3 pounds, he travels light and fast, and all alone. He flies up the east coast of the United States, heading straight into his toughest time of the year. Four weeks into his journey, he leaves New York City behind and turns northeast along the shore of Long Island Sound. Spread out below him is an osprey's movable feast, a watery maze left by glaciers many eons ago. This is the delta of the Connecticut River. Dredged and farmed for centuries, it's now hemmed in on both sides by houses and humans. Yet it remains a wild place, still governed by the tides and seasons. And it's here that the osprey was born. It's late March, and he's back in his home waters, where he first tasted fish, where he first learned to fly. His focus turns immediately to the most important piece of real estate in the marsh. It's an old piling standing just off an abandoned island. This was his true destination all along. It's just a ramshackle pile of sticks. But this is his nest, and he's come home early to reclaim it. After a long winter, it's a wonder it's still here. Yet before he can even start on repairs, there's a crisis. Eagles. This is trouble. Bald eagles are bigger, stronger than our osprey. They're known to attack osprey nests, taking eggs, even chicks. They may also be looking to build a nest of their own in his marsh. The eagles appear to be a young couple and not very experienced. And the male takes the bait. The osprey is battle-tested and launches his attack from above. Though he's much smaller, he's more agile in the air. Even an eagle respects the power of an osprey's lethal talons. For the young eagles, it's easier and safer to simply move on.